This is an original vintage Italian poster from 1962 for the film Lawrence of Arabia. The poster was in two sheets and heavily creased, so we flattened it out and joined the sheets together on a linen backing. And you'll see how we did that today on Poster Fix.
Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix. Linen backing is a process where we take a vintage poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. It's an archival process, meaning that it's good for the paper. It helps it last longer. It helps to neutralize the acids. It flattens out folds and creases, and it gives us a base from which to perform more restoration, like paper fills and color retouching.
When this poster came to us, it came in two large sheets. That's the way all Italian four-folio posters are. They're actually in two folios, but they're the size of 4-1 sheets. And there's not much wrong with this, except there's slight acid browning. And oh, look, there's writing on the back, which is showing through. This is permanent marker. It was done to designate what the poster was for the theater, but now it's bleeding through and I'm going to have to touch that up after it's linen backed. So now we are covering this acid-free paper with wheat paste. This paper will get mounted. We are lifting it up and putting it down onto the canvas. This is linen backing, and this is what the poster will get mounted to. Those two sheets will be put together on this acid-free paper. Hercules is taking a roller and pushing out all the excessive air pockets and excess wheat paste to make sure that the paper is hugging the canvas nice and flat. Now we're giving it a little lip around the outside, and now the screen is ready to have the poster mounted to it.
I'm gonna do this top half first, and then this bottom half.
The first thing we're going to do is lay the two sheets out onto the screen to see what its position is going to be on the screen. This is just a way of getting a sense of how much space there's going to be all around the poster so that we can average it out to get the most out of every side. And now that we know it, he's marked it off and is going to apply the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper so that we can then lay the paper down on top of that. Lawrence of Arabia is a 1962 British epic historical drama film based on the life of T.E. Lawrence and his 1926 book, Seven Pillars of Wisdom. It was directed by David Lean and produced by Sam Spiegel through his British company, Horizon Pictures, and distributed by Columbia Pictures. The film stars Peter O'Toole as Lawrence, with Alec Guinness playing Prince Faisal. The film also stars Jack Hawkins, Anthony Quinn, Omar Sharif, Anthony Quayle, Claude Rains, and Arthur Kennedy. The screenplay was written by Robert Bolt and Michael Wilson. We are rolling out the excess wheat paste. Lawrence of Arabia, a British production with American distribution, depicts Lawrence's experiences in the Ottoman Empire's provinces of Hejaz and Greater Syria during World War I, in particular his attacks on Aqaba and Damascus and his involvement in the Arab National Council. Its themes include Lawrence's emotional struggles with the personal violence inherent in war, his own identity, and his divided allegiance between his native Britain with its army and his newfound comrades within the Arabian desert tribes. And now we are laying down the second sheet. The second sheet will overlap the first sheet by 1 inch. That's why there is a specific order on which we put these pieces down. They have to be lined up a special way according to the crop marks. Lawrence of Arabia was nominated for 10 Oscars at the 35th Academy Awards in 1963. It won 7, including Best Picture and Best Director. It also won the Golden Globe Award for Best Motion Picture Drama and the BAFTA BAFTA Awards for Best Film and Outstanding British Film. The dramatic score by Maurice Jarre and the Super Panavision 70s cinematography by Freddie Young also won praise from the critics. The film is widely regarded as one of the greatest and most influential films ever made. In 1991, it was deemed culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant by the United States Library of Congress and selected for preservation in the National Film Registry. In 1998, the American Film Institute placed it on 5th on their 100 Years, 100 Movies list of the greatest American films, and it ranked 7th on their 2007 updated list. In 1999, the British Film Institute named the film the third greatest British film of all time. In 2004, it was noted the best British film of all time in a Sunday Telegraph poll of Britain's leading filmmakers. And now we're about completed in the rolling out of the second sheet. The two sheets are lined up quite well now, and it's time to go around the outer edge and to roll out the last lip of extra wheat paste, which has built up around the outer edge since we've been rolling out the inner area of the poster. The inks on this poster are very stable. And because the paper's wet, the acid burn that you see in the fold lines is more pronounced. But that will show much less after the poster is dry. And we found some extra air pockets in there. As you can see, this writing is a problem. We'll have to touch that up later. So we're going to take this sponge and clean off all this extra wheat paste so that we can have a nice, clean poster. We're going to let this screen dry for a few days before we trim down the poster. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
I just want to say that if you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, send me an email. Tell me their size, tell me their condition, and send me a few pictures, and I'll get back to you with a realistic assessment of what I think it's going to cost to restore them. We'll be right back. Well, that about wraps it up for this edition of Posterfix Studio. I appreciate the time you've given me showing you the restoration of vintage posters, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you very much.